Hi everyone! Oh my god, I know you've been wondering the same thing, which is where have I been? And I can explain to you in this video where exactly I have been and what I have been doing. So basically, I decided that I wanted to be more skilled in the field that I'm sort of, well, in the subject that I'm trying to show you how to do, which is nails and nail art and just anything like nails in general. And I decided to become a qualified nail technician, which I just graduated in 2 months ago in July. And then 2 weeks later, after I graduated and got my qualification, I got a job as a nail technician in Superdrug in Brighton, inside Churchill Square. At the moment, we've got like a mini nail bar, and yeah, I've just been doing a ton of strangers' nails. Basically, I've been doing gels, basic manis. I haven't quite got around to pedicures yet because no one's really asked yet. And yeah, so I decided to start my nail course in February of 2017, and then I finished in July. And I'm sorry that I haven't been posting much, but it is because that I decided to commit myself to my studies. And this year, in about 2 weeks' time, I'm going to be a beautician, because then I can actually show you like basic beauty sort of tips and stuff that they use in the salon. And yeah, so mainly my main interest is actually in nails. And I'm just coming on this live stream just to actually you know, show you a couple of things briefly that I've sort of bought and been up to. I mean, I probably won't show them all in one go in this video, otherwise it would be, you know, it would just be so long. But yeah, so this is actually my name badge, which I got, like, you know, at the beginning of my I guess employment at Superdrug as a nail technician. And it's been so good, you know. I've been learning so much, and you know, I've only just started my journey literally professionally as a professional nail technician, because my previous videos that you've seen on this channel were actually before I became a nail technician. So now that I actually am qualified, I can actually teach you a bit better, you know, how to prepare your nails before a manicure, and just painting your nails in general, and just a bunch of other things. So at the moment, the two things I am using to prepare nails with before a manicure or a pedicure is these two tools. So this thing here, in the purple tube, is the Orly Cutique, and I don't actually know if you could see that properly if I sort of, yeah, there we are, if I sort of shade this area. So this is the Orly Cutique, and it's really transparent, and this formula is basically designed to like resurface your nails. So I mean that by removing the debris and the excess cuticle that is not just sort of found here, which as nail technicians we call the matrix. So we call the cuticle the matrix. So it's not just found here, it's actually across the whole nail plate. And we use this formula to you know, make sure that the nail polish has a nice surface to stick on. And then we get this tool here, which is the cuticle pusher. So it's a cuticle pusher and a remover all in one. So if I just take it out of the tube, and I actually bought these from QVC, because when I went for my training last month, actually it's not last month, it was sort of like the last week in July, sort of 25th kind of date, I think. No, probably not even that actually. Yeah, probably the 25th of July. I went for a one-day training course that Superdrug send you to, and this is basically it's a gel training course, and it was so good, honestly. Yeah, so they taught us how to use this tool, and I will actually teach you how to use this at home, you know, and prepare your nails so that your nail polish has a nice base to stick to, but also so that the nail polish, like whatever you're putting on your nails, actually lasts longer. And yeah, so instead of me just sort of rambling on about like how it works, like in my other videos I will be posting in the future, I will actually show you how to do it, you know, setting up my camera properly and all that, you know, just so you can get a close up on my nails and what's happening and stuff. So yeah, so then ever since I started that training, I decided, because I had a little like scroll through my nail polishes that I have at the moment, and I found sort of this shade here, and I didn't realize it was an Ollie brand, you know, and yeah, so this is called, Orange Punch. So if I just show you there, it's called Orange Punch. I don't know if you can see that right there. So yeah, so this is just one of the oranges that they have, and this is like a bright neon orange, and I didn't actually choose this myself. I got this from a, not exactly beauty box, but a nail box called, I think it's called Nail Something. I can't quite remember quite the name of that nail box, but it sort of could be right under my nose, but this nail box has been discontinued, and it has been for the last year, and as at the time it came out, I just thought it was like a great idea because I'm a nail addict and I just wanted to try out different polishes. So it's a subscription box with different nail polishes in it, and Ollie was one of the nail polishes in that, and I just found this randomly, you know, just looking through my nail polish collection, and then I you know, I got three other shades. So these were on sale at 99p. I totally forgot where I got these from, but this is the shade Close Your Eyes. So yeah, so this is called Close Your Eyes, and this one is just like a really sparkly iridescent purple. Probably not that iridescent, but just like really sort of like a fine shimmery purple. And I decided to sort of use it with a converter I have, to convert normal nail polish to gel nail polish. And yeah, it stayed on and lasted just like a polish. And I'll show you that converter I used in a minute. So this is another shade. This is a really nice gold shade, like it's just a fine glitter gold, and this was also in the sale. This is called Buried Treasure. So that's called Buried Treasure, as you can see, and it is just a really nice sort of iridescent, not iridescent, I keep saying that, but you know, sort of just like sparkly fine glitter gold. And there's another one called In the Navy here, and this is just like a really like nice shimmery dark blue. And I'm such like a tomboy when it comes to the colours, because I don't like pink, unfortunately, but yeah, I'll go for other colours, like probably not the neon colours like orange, pinks and you know whatnot, maybe bright blue or bright purple, but you know, that's the exception. And so yeah, so I'll just like show you the converter that I've been using. And if you're wondering what exactly a converter is, the way you use it is, it's got hair in this, sort of this has been lying around like my room for long because I'm taking a break from gels. So this is called the Chroma Advanced Gel. So this is a gel converter, and I've got another one called Sensational. So basically a gel converter is just like a gel formula. So inside it just looks like clear gel. If I was to sort of take the lid off, I know it's all sticky, and I'll just show you how it looks like on the inside. It's just this gel here that, you know, is clear and transparent, and, you know, you use this to mix your normal nail polish with, and you paint it over your nails, and you use it with a gel lamp, and it just turns a normal nail polish into a gel nail polish, and it wears the same as a gel nail polish. But you know, if you're a non-nail technician, you know, I'm not saying this like, you know, sort of how do you call that, sort of like proudly or whatever, but if you're a non-nail technician, they sell this to the public, and they sell Sensationnail, which is the exact same sort of like formula to the public, because they can't sell gels mainly to the public, because gels can irritate the skin if you don't wipe it off your skin, or at least file it off with a nail file after you're done. But yeah, as this is just as an alternative, like, you know, but if you sort of qualify to be a nail technician, if you're a qualified nail technician, you can actually get hold of gels and use them on yourself, obviously, as well as other people, because you've been qualified to use them. So that is the converter. And then what you would do beforehand, though, is before you use that converter, you would use the bonder first. So this actually bonds the nail to the gel. So this is a double-sided sticky tape kind of formula. So this is the first thing you put under before anything else. And then after that, you would use the tub of gel I just showed you, the converter, and then you would use sort of two coats of that on top of that, because basically you have to mix like a couple of drops of your nail polish with the converter. You paint it on, then you paint about one or two coats of the converter itself, just as the gel itself, and then you would put on top of that the gel finishing touch top coat. So this is everything's really sticky right now because I think my tub of gel leaked, but yeah, so I'm not gonna sort of expose this to the light too long because you're not meant to do that. But this is the top coat that you'd use on top of that, so on top of your gel converter, and it is quite pricey. It is about £50. I think that's what it came to when I bought it, but it was a set, so alone the gel converter. So alone, if you were just to buy this alone and had your very own gel top coat, then that would be, I think, about £35 for this tub alone. But then for an extra 15, you get it with, actually I got it with the finishing touch, so these two together I got in a set, and I'll actually post a link, you know, just linking you to what I just got. So that was the set for £50, and then this separately, the bonder, I'm not sure how much it was, but I'll still post the link to the product basically in the description bar, which you can then come back to. I'm just putting this back. So those are the things that I've bought, and my fingers are quite sticky just because I think my gel leaked. So yeah, so definitely try and keep a tight seal. But then just like another thing I'd just like to touch on is I managed to get hold of something really amazing and neat, and this is called the Shoal foot file. So this is a waterproof foot file. I think it's called Wet and Go or something like that. And it's a rechargeable one. I'll just show you the charger real quick. So this is the charger you would use it with, and because it's non-battery operated and stuff, you know, it's pretty easy to sort of remember to charge, and you know, you don't need to buy batteries continuously. And also it's waterproof, so you can use it under the shower. So if you think thick skin sort of grows continuously, just use that. It's a really easy tool, and you know, easy to incorporate into your daily routine as well. So try and use that. And so also another thing which is beauty related but not quite nail related that I got is this Clarisonic brush. And I'm just touching it like that because, you know, my hands are really sticky. But so this Clarisonic brush is basically the Clarisonic Smart Profile. So this is the most expensive brush that I got out of the whole set. And if I just sort of clip on one brush, you know, it just clips on by pushing one of the brushes onto the device, and it would sort of be like that. And so basically it's just really useful for cleaning your face and your makeup off of your face. And I probably might review it in a video, I'm not sure, but I'm just sort of whizzing through a bunch of things without trying to take too long, although this is like 15 minutes already. So yeah, so I will be returning with some new nail knowledge that I have acquired over the last couple of months. And I'm terribly sorry that I did go missing, but I will be back, and I might even do more live streams. I'm not sure. I might do like a post once a month or something. I'm not too sure right now, but I will try and catch you when I can. But I have not disappeared. I have not gone. So that's some good news for you there. So yeah, don't forget also to subscribe to me. Hit the subscribe button, and you know, in one of my videos soon, I might be showing you how to do a basic cut, file and buff, and obviously using the, you know, the Orlie, you know, the Orlie pusher, cuticle pusher and remover, plus the Cutique. You will have like this perfect mani at home without having to go to a salon just for that. And then I'll just talk about a bunch of other things, like, you know, what to expect in a manicure or pedicure, like a basic and luxe manicure, you know, and gels, you know, at salon. So yeah, just like loads of other subjects, nail related subjects mostly. So yeah, I hope that you have actually missed me, because I did miss you, but you know, yeah, so don't forget, subscribe, and yeah, just keep up with me. So I will see you, maybe next week, maybe next month, who knows. But yeah, just have a good day, week, month, year. So I'll see you then. Bye.